HMS Prince of Wales is the seventh ship to carry the name, with the first launched in 1765. The £3.3 billion carrier, with a full crew of 1,600, was formally commissioned in December 2019, and Gibraltar is her first non-UK port visit. She is massive, more than 280 metres long and 70 metres wide, with 4-acre flight decks, the centrepiece of the carrier strike group.
I mean, we've had a long journey, as in a long journey from when we were built. Back in 2019, when we came out of Rosyth, we entered into Portsmouth and commissioned in front of Her Royal Highness the Duchess of Cornwall. And then since that time, we've been working up, and we've been doing not only capability insertion periods, but also maintenance, but also training. And that's where we've just come from. So we've just been on the south coast under the auspices of Fleet Operational Sea Training Staff, and they have put us through our paces for about 4 weeks. And that's everything from firefighting, damage control, floods. These are all exercises, and then also some aviation as well. So then to be able to be released and get a strong, satisfactory pass, we then passaged down over the last 3 or 4 days to arrive in Gibraltar. And absolutely brilliant to be here, I have to say, and the ship's company are very excited, because many of them have never seen Gibraltar, never been ashore in Gibraltar, and this is their first foreign run ashore.
The Prince of Wales can operate more than twice as many larger and heavier aircraft compared with the former Invincible class. Her capabilities include range tracking radar of up to 250 nautical miles, a highly mechanised weapon handling system, and magazine complexes capable of stowing a full range of F35-B and maritime helicopter weapons. For the younger members of her crew, Gibraltar is their first run ashore away from Portsmouth and comes towards the end of an intense training period.
Yes, so since we left the UK, we've done some deck landing practice to get us confident doing that by day and by night. We've also done some practice at winching and lifting loads and returning them safely to the deck. And then we've moved on to some other flying as well, sort of scenario-based flying.
So I'm a student observer, so similar part to Martin in terms of flying next to the aircraft, more of the tactical side, the tactical mission commander, going out, building the picture, looking at all the sensors, that sort of thing.
Well, it's really exciting for me because it's my first trip away abroad since COVID. It's my first run ashore with the Navy. It's my first time abroad with the Navy. So a lot of firsts for me, which is fantastic.
We've sort of just gone through quite a tough period of training on board. We've gone through basic sea training where the crew for the first time has been learning to fight fires and deal with emergencies effectively. So to be able to come here at the end of it all before we go back to Portsmouth is a nice treat, and I think we're all going to make the most of it, yeah.
The sheer vastness of the carrier is mind-boggling. The hangar floor space covers just under 5,000 square metres, and the entire ship, with its 16 decks, weighs 65,000 tonnes.
I'm standing on the flight deck of the Prince of Wales, and it is vast. You could fit nearly 3 football pitches on here. And at its highest point, it reaches 56 metres, all 65,000 tonnes of her. In fact, there's enough power on board for a town the size of Swindon. And right now, I'm standing on the ramp where the F-35s will take off.
Gibraltar remains a key strategic base for these aircraft carriers, which makes a significant contribution to NATO deterrence and defence.
It's an important base for us, in actual fact, and particularly now as we look at the global Britain policy. And the fact is we've now got 2 aircraft carriers, obviously with Queen Elizabeth now on her maiden deployment, CSG-21, and obviously my own ship down here as well, representing global Britain. It is an important place. But also, I have family links here. I do, and I think, you know, it's an important place to come to. Part of my family grew up here, and this was my first visit as a young midshipman when I was about 19 in 1989. So it has an important place in my heart, but also an important place in the Royal Navy's heart as well. In the autumn, we start with deck qualifications with the F-35. So we actually landed on our first F-35 about 3 weeks ago as part of a trial to make sure that we can take the F-35s. And then, as I say, in the autumn, we'll be doing some more training for them, but also putting the ship through some more training as well, some more operational training. And then after that, we will be declaring the ship to NATO as the Allied Command Platform, as the NATO Reaction Force. And the United Kingdom has done that for basically declaring this ship as its flagship for 1 year.
The visit marks another significant milestone in the ROC's maritime history. Following a short logistics stop, she'll return home to Portsmouth, her operational sea training successfully completed.